we're here to show you a 24-foot Rambler model. This was the fifth house we built. It's gently used, about 3.5 years old, of our earlier work, because in the early days of the business, we were so busy running the business and trying to stay on top of the builds, which isn't easy, that we got let this get away without getting a good video of it. So here's your opportunity to see it. And so this one is built with structural insulated panels, which is a great way to build tiny houses on wheels. It's much more structurally sound. It's about 3 times stronger than conventional 2x4 framing. And this house has been moved about 5 or 6 times and has held up wonderfully. So y'all want to go inside and take a look?
I know they do.
All right. So we got the board and batten exterior here. Oh, this one has the black vinyl window upgrade and a cedar exterior, cedar accent panel. And then you got the full light door with the blinds between the glass.
I'll try to get a good shot before we go all the way in. So this is our reclaimed accent wall that we made with, was this one fence pickets?
Fence pickets, yep. Did a cool design there. Me and our lead carpenter at that time kind of sketched something out and came up with this design, and turned out great, I think.
This new gimbal I have doesn't let me do the wide angle that I usually do, so hopefully we'll get the whole house eventually.
All right, where do you want to start?
I guess the kitchen.
All right, so this is a 24-foot house, and it does have a full kitchen. It's got a slat-out pantry here with the soft close.
Oh, I wasn't quite down low enough. Try that again.
Sorry.
It's got
two shelves in it. It's got the toe kick drawers down below. So we were doing that even early on. It's got a full stove with 4 burners in a oven, the microwave, another pull-out pantry here, and another one on the other side of the sink. Got the apron front farmhouse sink, which is a nice, that's our standard sink now. At that time, it was an upgrade. Apartment-sized fridge with the pedestal drawer to raise it up off the floor, so it's easier access.
And more toe kicks than the one you just opened.
Yeah, there are a couple more under there.
So above, people ask, why do we have a catwalk? So some people have cats, but even if you don't have a cat, it's a good place to see how the light is there. It gives a good place to put the vent and attach the vent for the above the stove. And then we put lights. A lot of times we'll put lights in that space. And then it gives you a place to put some plants or storage bins or whatever you want.
And a lot of times we'll put clerestory windows. We don't have it in this one, but a lot of our houses do have the clerestory windows up there above that catwalk. So it helps with the for plants as well. And then we've got the storage stairs. This one has 4 drawers in it. So lots of storage, doors and drawers, and that's where the trash can is in this one. You want to go through to the bathroom?
All right, so this was the first stand-up loft we built, right? Here's another frequently asked question. Everybody asks, why don't you have storage in the bed platform? So you see the bed platform is here, and then the bathroom is here. 6'8" head clearance in the bathroom?
Six, I think.
Huh.
Close.
You told me 6'8".
I could be wrong. I was wrong one of those times. I might be wrong both times.
You've told me 6'8" more often than you've told me 6'6". Because I know it's 6'4" in the loft, correct?
Yeah.
So this is where the washing machine goes. You can see the connections. And then the water heater is behind this door here.
That's a full-size soaking tub there.
What else you want to say about this bathroom?
It's got everything you need. It's full-size.
Yeah. I agree. Lots of floor. I'm going to show the floor space. Yeah, they put some good hooks here for you.
And then we've got the,
how big is the bathroom?
That one, I think it's 5 feet wide by 7 feet front to back.
Okay.
And then the living area here is a nice living space. There's a pull-down screen here.
Yeah, they have this.
And then a projector up above. And so this house is equipped with blackout shades all throughout the house. So even in the daytime, you can close all the blackout shades and still watch a movie on the projector.
It gets really dark
In
here. So they put this in. Of course, we could take it out if you want. But it's a pretty cool system here, and it's pretty easy to. They even taught me how to use it with the remote.
Yeah, very easy to use.
Lots of space here in the living room. Full-size sofa.
Full-size
you could do
sofa.
A sleeper sofa if you wanted. There's plenty of room.
Plenty of room for lounging.
Picture windows. And then we got clerestory windows on this side, which all have blackout shades. And they've even got a remote for those ones that are hard to reach.
Now, this is the original stand-up loft.
So, we can add one of those steps here. That these guys, this is before we got smart and started building in steps, but we just retrofit another house with a little step. So, if you want, we can do that for you. So, it's a single wardrobe with the hanging space and three drawers. Queen size bed platform?
Yes, queen size bed.
So tons of storage there. And then plugs, that lamp and, I didn't turn it on. That lamp and that fan are plugged in over there in that corner.
Yeah.
And then if you want, you can put a little curtain right here if you want privacy, but this one's just open. And then here's the egress window, of course. There we go. Oh, yeah, emergency exit.
And this one does have a really cool ceiling fan. It looks like a airplane propeller.
Oh, yeah. I'll show that once I get back down. So this is a cool, it looks like a piece of art when it's, but you can. This is a good place to hang your towel when you come upstairs after your after your bath.
After you soak in the tub.
In the soaking tub. Okay, what else? We need to talk about sips.
Structural insulated panels.
This house is made of sips.
Yeah, they're stronger and more lightweight. They have a structural panel on the outside, a structural panel on the inside, with which are glued to foam. And they only have 2x4s on the perimeters and around the windows. So it's got fewer 2x4s, which is what makes it lighter. But the two structural panels sandwiching that foam and glued to it create such a strong structure that it makes this house almost a monolithic structure where it has very little flex when you're driving down the road, minimizes the movement of the house itself. And so it's our favorite way to build tiny houses. It has its pluses and minuses. Like the electrical is a little harder to do in the sips than 2x4 framing. But
we found a new sips manufacturer that has more pluses than minuses because they help a lot with the electrical. And then they put it together for us instead of sending it to us in a stack of panels.
Right. We take the trailer to them. They pre-run a lot of the wire for us, which that's a huge help, and pre-assembly saves us time and money, because sips do cost more.
So I'm going to show the house while you keep talking about sips, because we'll close out, and I'll refer at the end of the video. I'll give you a link to. See the video of our sips manufacturer Peter just made.
Yeah, Turnkey Fabrication. They're based out of Fort Worth, Texas.
And they talk even more about the strength and the R value, and it's a way better insulator because it's not just is it a better R value in with the styrofoam, but it's also a tighter seal. There are not as many tiny places where air can get in and out, right. So which makes ventilation important. Here we can see a little vent up there.
Pressure inlet.
Yeah, and we always have the fresh air inlet and then two fans that exhaust to the outside. That's standard, and then you can do fancier. We've got an air filter down there right now. And and I was going to show this fan. So it's a really sturdy form of construction. I'm trying to show the...
Will it not tilt up?
It's cute. It looks like an airplane propeller.
All right.
Yeah. Anything else about SIPs?
I think that's...
Y'all watch that SIPs video and you'll learn some more.
All right. Well, thanks for tuning in. Be sure to click subscribe and click notifications. And give us a thumbs up.